and welcome to soundproofguide.com. In this video, I'll be talking about the do's and don'ts of when you're building a home theater, or if you already have a home theater and there are ways to make it sound much better. Because even looking online at, if you just Google home theater pictures or DIY ideas, you'll definitely see in some of those pictures big mistakes. Stuff that you should not do if you care more about what the home theater will sound like while you're watching a movie than what it looks like when you're, well, I guess watching a movie, because if you're not watching a movie, you probably won't even be there to see what it looks like. So there is a few things that you can do to make your home theater sound a lot better right now that will not cost you that much, and that's not that difficult to do. But let's say right now you have a room that you want to make a home theater with. Let's say the room is finished. Well, if it's finished, then it's kind of like this basement where there's already a wall. If you're a little bit handy, the thing I would strongly suggest doing would be to take the drywall off and to install some acoustic soundproof insulation. A lot of places calls it different things. Usually it's not called soundproof insulation, but it's usually called sound deadening insulation, acoustic insulation. If you buy insulation like that, it will be a little bit more money, but it will also have more acoustical soundproofing properties within the insulation itself to help in sound absorption mainly, and also to absorb a lot of the vibrations that a home theater will create while you're watching a movie. If you want to know more about soundproof insulation, you can watch that video, and I'll also be giving you some advice on which ones to buy and avoid. That's the first thing that you want to do. Let's say that you don't want to touch the wall, fine. The results won't be as good, but they will be better than doing nothing at all. The second thing that you should do, of course, I mentioned this in a lot of videos when I talk about soundproofing walls, would be to add a second layer of drywall on top of it. Don't add the half inch drywall that you probably already have on your wall. Add a 5/8 inch drywall. It's a thicker, more sturdier drywall. It will only cost you a few dollars more per sheet, and it's worth it. It will stop sound a lot more than just the standard half inch drywall. Now, if you want to go a little bit further, you can add a layer of mass loading vinyl between the two layers of drywall. Sometimes I say that you can add some type of acoustical compound between these walls. It's not as effective, let's say, as the mass loaded vinyl is concerned regarding a home theater. The reason for that is, again, with the vibration that the bass will create. Now, let's say that you did not take the drywall off of the wall to install insulation or just do anything behind that first layer drywall to better soundproof the wall. Let's say you didn't do that. So now you just have most likely a half inch insulation where you're going to put a 5/8 inch insulation on top of it. Adding the mass loaded vinyl will make quite a difference in absorbing a lot of the vibrations that the bass will create, and it will also help in deadening a lot of the sound that the speakers creates when you're watching a movie. Now, this is going to be a little bit more expensive, of course, than using some type of acoustical compound, but it will be a lot more effective than an acoustical compound. And if you want to know more about mass loaded vinyl, I also have a video explaining everything there is to know about mass loaded vinyl, if it's safe to use, if there's any odor, how to install it, what type of mass loaded vinyl that you can use. That video up there will tell you anything that you want to know about mass loaded vinyl. So now that you've taken care of better soundproofing the wall, now you want to better acoustics in the home theater room. And one of the biggest don'ts, one of the biggest mistakes that I see people do is that they have posters on the walls. of different movies, like they have at the movies. At the movies, when you walk in, they usually have those big glass cabinets with a poster that says Showtime or Coming Soon or Playing Now. They look nice, but one thing that it's going to do in your home theater room, adding glass in front of a wall that's already flat, is just going to make the sound wave bounce all around the room. It just won't sound as good as it can. Now, you're probably watching this and saying, well, geez, my home theater room sounds really good. Well, it can sound a lot better by just take them off. Somebody's gonna buy them off you, put them online. So I guarantee you, somebody that hasn't watched this video will want those. There you go, you've got them sold. Replace them with something like this. Acoustic panels. Acoustic panels will work a lot better than your typical acoustic foam. These ones are mostly for when you have a recording studio. It's mostly for a small room that you just put them all over the wall, and it just makes the recording sound better. But in a home theater room, you'll want something more like this, that looks better. You can get acoustic panels in any shapes, colors, sizes, thickness. You can get some that are just one inch thick. You can get some that are 2 inches thick. You can get different colors, different shapes. And yes, they cost more money, but I mean, if you're already spending money to build a home theater room, then you might as well at least do what you can to make it sound as good as it should. Another thing that a lot of people do is they have a lot of leather furniture, a lot of leather couches. And of course, a leather Lazy Boy recliner is quite comfortable, but it will reflect sound a little bit more than a plush couch made of a more sound absorbing material than a leather couch. And of course, a lot of people will have 8 chairs in their home theater, and most of the time only use one. Well, if you're going to fill your room up with furniture, you might as well fill the room up with furniture that is going to be a type of material that will absorb sound. So one of the don'ts is leather seating. I know, okay, if I had a home theater room, I would probably put the leather seating also, because it looks kind of good. But just for acoustics and sound, a material, it just sounds better anyway. Another big don't that I would say that a lot of home theater rooms have is built-ins. Now, it's not so bad if you have a built-in for a big screen TV, but if you have a built-in where you place your speakers in, yes, it looks a lot better. Some built-ins looks pretty good. They have the speakers in with a little pot light shining down, and it looks actually really good. But one thing that it does that those people probably don't think about is the sound from the speakers don't only come out the front, it comes from everywhere of the speaker. Most of it comes from the front, but a lot of the noise comes from the sides. And the speaker is built a certain way so that the sound comes out sounding the way it should be. The thing is, if you built a built-in and you put the speaker inside the built-in, well, you're almost creating a speaker box over top another speaker box. And that will distort the sound of what the speaker is supposed to sound like. Now, finally, the only thing that's left is the floors and ceilings. 99% of the time, I don't see anything on the ceiling, which is fine for the most part, but if you have a big, long media room, then having acoustics on the ceiling is not a bad idea, because that's a large, flat surface that will just bounce the sound waves from the ceiling down to the floor. We'll talk about the floor in a minute. You're not going to put these types of acoustic panels on the ceiling. You can, but they're not really made for ceilings. They do have some acoustic panels, which they are called acoustic clouds or acoustic sound clouds, something like that. And they are made specifically for the ceiling and they look really good. They work better for what it's for, mainly the ceiling, of course, and it'll work better than using these types of acoustic panels. They do cost a little bit more money, but you don't need a lot of them. 3 or 4 just scattered around just to kind of break the flatness of the surface is all you need. So now that you've taken care of the ceiling, it's now time to take care of the floor. Now, a lot of home theaters will have carpeting on the floor. Well, that's perfect. If you have carpeting for flooring, if you already have a noise absorbing material, perfect. You don't have to, the floor's covered. But a lot of places, they'll have tiles or hardwood floor. Now, if that's the case, you want to take care of that by adding a rug. If you have a hard surface, adding an area rug will immediately deaden a lot of the noise that comes down, and it will also help with the vibration that the bass creates. So by having sound clouds or acoustic clouds on the ceiling and a nice area rug on the ground, add some acoustic panels and get rid of all those glass posters, and you'll be well on your way to making your home theater not only more soundproof, but by doing that, you'll make it sound a lot better. Feel free to take a look at many of our other YouTube videos and also some of our articles on our website, soundproofguide.com. Don't forget to click the like button if you enjoyed this video, and also consider subscribing to our channel if you like our content. Also, feel free to leave us a comment below if you have any soundproofing questions of your own. We will certainly try our very best to help you. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next video or any other videos in our channel. Thank you very much.